that, eh? Are we there yet?
Shut up!
Merry Christmas, everybody! So, we looked through our Iceland vlog stuff that we had from last year, and we realized we were having too much fun to actually talk to the camera. So we're gonna do that now. It's Cello and me right now, and it is Christmas Eve. We are really excited to share this with you all tomorrow. And yeah, let's get to it.
This is on the way to the Golden Circle, where we stopped briefly for a landscape view of what Iceland looks like.
Oh, look at my feet.
Whoa. Ew.
I'm gonna film this.
I remember when we first started driving and the terrain around us was like squishy.
It is a very strange sensation, satisfying while being disgusted. I was very obsessed with it.
This view, if we don't take it, it's a piece of time.
That's probably just what you see every day in Iceland, where people just casually cross the highway with horse.
This is the ass to fat, so the ass is.
The Great Geysir and Stroker Geysir, and then the Gullfoss Waterfall. Gullfoss Waterfall. So here is a clip of that waterfall. It was really magnificent, but it was cold because, you know, it was Iceland. Yeah, wow, look how many people were there. This is such a pre-COVID thing to witness.
Oh yes, this waterfall, even though it doesn't look like it, it makes everybody who walks up to it extremely wet because of the fog that it created. It's not like fog as in we know the fog, it's more like rain, but sideways. I remember here we went a little bit adventurous, but eventually we decided we cannot keep on going anymore because this road just leads nowhere. And here you can see me trying really hard to stand still in the strong wind and guide Jeffrey to do a 5-point U-turn. Is it 5-point?
It was more like a... Yeah, it was like a 20-point U-turn. I just love that you couldn't get your jacket on.
Hey, there's a strong wind, okay? Oh my god, why do I look so ridiculous? I swear I'm not acting. I'm trying to kick the stone away on the road so the car can pass. But somehow it looks ridiculous. Slow-mo video of an explosion of a geyser. I think I pronounced that correctly. Is that called geyser?
Yeah, that was crazy. Also, we waited so long for a good one, and you were the only one who got a good video of a good explosion. Like, the other ones were kind of just like, and then missed off into the distance.
Each explosion is different, sometimes big, sometimes small, but they have one thing in common, is I think they don't smell particularly good.
I forgot about that. Yeah, it smells like rotten eggs.
Because there is minerals from underneath the earth that are just being ejected into the air. I believe the RPN, as Jeffrey said, this is the pimple of the earth.
And you called it the fart of the earth.
Yeah, because of the smell. It's unforgettable. I remember the topic was to find the most appropriate music for the scene. I think we tried Mahler, we tried Shostakovich, we tried Planet, Jupiter.
This is the Þingvellir Park, and I think the Game of Thrones was filmed here. It felt like we were on Mars or something.
And I think there's a very good reason, because not only the plants look very different, but at the same time their geographic formation of the rocks, of the structure, looks very different from any island that we've ever been to. It looks very interesting, even though I think these are all naturally formed, but it looks almost like a human just paved this entire wall.
Yeah. Because it's so thin, like it's just one giant slab. Also, it's a UNESCO World Heritage Site, and I remember Ben always wanted to point out when it was a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Like, anytime he went anywhere, and we visited a lot of them, he was like, oh, the greatest part about it is that it's UNESCO World Heritage.
Ben Bartelt is literally a moving Wikipedia. He knows the corners of the knowledge that nobody ever will even think of searching it, but he actually knows it, which is pretty amazing.
That was probably my favorite day of our whole contract.
Actually, 2 days. Because our ship docked at a port for overnight, which means that you have 2 full days to explore the neighborhood area where your ship was docked.
Yo, what's up?
Can we try again?
Yo, what's up? We're almost there. Blue Lagoon?
Blue Lagoon! Woo!
Soon, but if you do have a chance, we'd love to go.
Yeah.
So let us know in the comment below. And subscribe and like. No, like and subscribe.
Bye, everyone.